The word monsoon is often used to describe heavy rainstorms, but they're actually defined by wind, and understanding how they work could help us learn more about wildfires.
So monsoon is a atmospheric circulation, an atmospheric pattern of wind that is the size of a continent that typically switches on in early summer and delivers water to the continent for the whole season.
The wind sends ocean moisture inland, where it comes down in bouts of soaking rain.
There's a South American monsoon that delivers water to the Amazon rainforest. There's monsoons in Africa, Northern Africa and Southern Africa, in Northern Australia, as well as in Asia.
And there was a monsoon pattern in Western North America. Recently, Dr. Boos's research at UC Berkeley found that it may actually operate differently from any of those other monsoon patterns. Typically, the hot summer sun heats up the land and kicks off a persistent wind pattern where warm, moist air flowing inland then rises persistently, leading to repeated rounds of heavy rainfall. But the Southwest monsoon, which is focused from the west coast of Mexico into the Four Corners, is more likely driven by the jet stream.
That jet stream, that big current of air, actually hits mountains on the west coast of North America, gets deflected and moves down toward the equator into the monsoon region and then up over the mountains, and that produces the rainfall.
Here in Northern California, we get occasional rounds of thunderstorms from that monsoon pattern. Those storms can spark wildfires in the Sierra. So it's important to us to understand why the North American monsoon does what it does.
In order to make a prediction of something, we want to understand how it works before we predict how it'll work in the future.
In the future, climate change could alter the Southwest monsoon's behavior. That could mean weather changes for Northern California.
We're in this sort of like sporadic, diffuse edge of the North American monsoon, and any fluctuations therefore have a bigger effect, because we're sort of hanging on for these sort of episodic, relatively rarer, weaker events.
Discoveries from research like Dr. Boos can be used to help improve weather and climate forecasting models to better predict just how those weather changes may play out. That could help provide more insight into conditions that can cause wildfires in the West. I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman for KCRA 3 News.